Today I'm reviewing the Logi Rally Bar, not the Mini, the Bar. This is it over here. I like to call it the Beast. Like to know what I thought? Well, stick around. I'm Paul Bloom, and this is In My Humble Opinion. The Logi Rally Bar is indeed a beast. It's a beautiful bit of design. It's got a very nice form factor. It is a whopping 3 feet long. It's almost 7 kilograms. I think actually it's just over 7 kilograms in weight. It's the largest Android-driven Teams Room system all in one that I've laid my hands on to date. In fact, I think it's the largest one that there is in the market today. So what we're going to do is, firstly, we'll look at the actual hardware physically and have a look at what we see and first impressions of that. Then we're going to connect up the unit, get it up and running, and I'll walk you through that process. I'm also going to be doing a demonstration of the audio and video quality a little bit later on. And throughout all of that, I'll be pointing out what makes this unit unique in this space. Let's get started. So just coming into the back of the Rally Bar, you'll see I've got the cover off over there, and on the left hand side we've got power, we've got our mic pod, which is for additional mic pods. You can have up to three, and our three USB-A ports. There's a little cable management system, that little foam bit over there, and then on the right side, HDMI ingest. Now that's not quite turned on just yet in the operating system. That'll be out very, very soon, and you'll be able to do screen share via HDMI cable on an Android unit very soon, within the next couple of weeks, I've been told. Then we've got the two HDMI outputs, which allows you to have up to two screens on this unit, Ethernet, and then of course our USB-C, and that's for the BYOD option when you want to plug in your laptop or something like that. Of course, the unit does do Wi-Fi connect as well, but as with any room system, it's not probably a good idea to run your meeting rooms off a Wi-Fi connection. You certainly won't get the best experience, so Ethernet it is. And on the far right-hand side of the unit, we've got a reset button over there, reboot. A Bluetooth connect button, and of course the power button, which is really cool. It means you don't have to unplug the power if you want to do anything over there. And when you hold these buttons in, you get an on-screen display prompt that tells you what to do to get the specific action sorted as you would expect. So I've connected my Rally Bar to power, and I have it connected to my network and also to my HDMI screen. This is the output of my HDMI screen you're seeing over here. I've done it in this way, so you've got a clear view of it. And it gives me this selection of providers I can connect it to. No more loading this image or that image depending on what you're going to do. That's really cool. I like that. Clicking on Teams, that's my focus today. Tells me about the remote. The remote comes with a little sticker. Watch out that you don't lose it. And when you put that on, that little blank button becomes a Teams button. So really clever. I like that little addition. And then, of course, we can now connect additional USB accessories. Perhaps it's a tap, or perhaps it's something else, depending on your use case. So I'll just validate that I've got that connected there. Very good. And so now we go through this little setup. It tells us about what we're going to do, what the capabilities are of the remote. Now, of course, if you're using a touch panel, then, you know, the remote has a limited functionality. And of course, if you don't have a touch screen, then it does make a bit more sense. We move on. You get to the screen over here. I'm going to jump onto my mobile phone. I'm going to that Microsoft.com/device login page. I love this really cool companion assisted login system that we're now seeing across all of the Android devices. I'm actually seeing it on other things as well. I just saw it on Disney Plus just a week or two ago. Love it. Great idea. Makes logging in so much easier. And here we go. Don't have to put in any username or password. It's marrying it up based on the credentials on my mobile, and boom, we're done. Look at that. Isn't that incredible? Right, so just using the remote, I'm navigating the menu over there, going down to device settings. If you don't need a touch panel, then the remote will suffice. 1, 2, 3, 4 is the default pin to get in there. I'm just looking at Sync. Sync is a great Logitech specific tool. You can connect to it over there. You need a Sync account in the cloud, and what this allows you to do is to connect your devices to a cloud instance. You can have multiple meeting rooms in there. It'll also do other things like cameras and speakers and that sort of thing, as long as they're in the catalog of supported devices. And I already have an account in Sync, so I'm going to put in the credentials over here. And any device I want to marry up to Sync, I'd sign in with these same credentials. And what that'll do is it'll contact Sync from the MTR. It's doing so right now, logging it into Sync, tying it up. There's my organization. And it's going to take the unit's original name, the name it has now, as you can see. It'll connect. It says it disconnect from Sync. If I look at the room details, this room in particular, remember I'm on this room, you'll see it's called Rally Bar, blah, blah, whatever the default is, right? And I've put a seat count of 18 there earlier. But look at that. It says there, you can't change that from the device because it's now associated, affiliated to Sync. So I'm going to go into the Sync portal over here. And there it is. You can see all the other devices I have. Here's my laptop and my Brio and so on. And just going into the Rally Bar, I'm just going to change that. Don't like that name too much. And I'm going to reduce the seat count to 6. Although 6 is fairly low for a Rally Bar. You probably want to go bigger, not smaller. But yeah, just for the sake of demonstration, I'll update that. And that'll push that change back to my Rally Bar on its unit locally. So this was the cloud service, remember? There's a bunch of other stuff you can do in Sync. You can see what's been going on, changes that have been made. You can look at things like the version. You can push out updates. You can change settings and configuration and that sort of thing. Moving over to the video, we can see that they have right sight. This is Logitech's own technology. It allows you to track human figures, pan, tilt, zoom, that sort of stuff, uses right sight. You can turn it off so that it's only on call or dynamic. Little bug here in system, time zones reported incorrectly, but nothing major. Right, let's get back to our MTR. Let's move away from the actual Sync website and back onto the local unit. This is it over here. We've got all these different aspects we've been looking at. Firstly, you'll see that our name and our seat count has now been updated. Also, if we look at updates, 1.3, 1.4 is the new one with the HDMI inbound sharing, but that's coming soon. Looking at the display mode, we've got a bunch of different things. An additional display you could connect. You can change the theme from light to dark, as I have. Here's my favorite bit. You can test your speakers and your microphone right from here. I really like that. That's a really nice addition. We've got speaker boost, AI noise suppression, reverb control, which I've pushed up to aggressive. We've got microphone bass boost. We've got voice boost. All sorts of settings, which I really like to see and really do encourage you to have a play with to get the best possible sound out of your Rune system. Right, having a look now at the camera again. You can set up the camera from here, make a change to how it behaves, turn on and off room occupancy, do a camera test, all that sort of stuff, which is really handy. It's great for when you're trying to test things without actually being able to get into the call. Make sure the connectivity's there, get a feel for the clarity of the camera, that sort of stuff. I'm not going to do that because you can look into the back of my head. So, instead, let's get back to main menu settings over here. We've got connectivity, we've got IP addressing, if you want to know what that is, all that kind of usual stuff. Looking at peripherals, we can add more remotes or replace a remote or add pods. And then here in systems. Now here in systems, remember I said that I was in New Zealand time? See, I am in New Zealand time, so a little bug over there won't bring that up again. Power saving features are really cool because you can change the way it works over here. Now, one of the things I've done is I have not put in a tap at the moment in the current state, although I do have one here that I've been playing with. So that's not there, but I've turned the AI viewfinder on to track whether there's someone in the room or not. And then I've turned the display off for that. Now I'm just going to pause here for a moment before we test this. This is HDMI CEC control. So what it does is it allows the signals from HDMI to wake up or put to sleep, to turn off or to turn on your screen. Could be a TV, could be a commercial screen. This is an easy way to test whether your display is HDMI CEC compliant. That's at Consumer Electronics Control Standard. I'll run the test real quickly here. Now, I do have a CEC compliant screen, and I would say that you don't want to put a screen in that isn't CEC compliant. However, I'm currently actually connected to an HDMI ingest to my PC, so you're not actually seeing the screen behavior, but you're seeing something else. Right, it's time for us to actually set up a call, check out that quality, get an experience with the audio and the video and the tracking and the panning and tilting and zooming and all that kind of stuff. Here we go.
You probably have found out by now, Teams recordings, well, it doesn't actually record the live experience. It's a reduced quality. And so now instead, what I'm doing is on my PC, I'm grabbing the actual video coming in, and I'm also recording the system audio as it's being delivered. So it's the Logi Rally Bar that's collecting this information, and it's wired into my network, and it's sending that off, and we're in a call over here, and of course I'm picking it up as the secondary participant of the call. So over here, I'm placing my Brio. Now, I must tell you, though, that a Brio is an incredible camera. So everything you see here, these phones and the actual rally bar, is from the Brio. And at this distance, the Brio is actually very hard to beat. But just turning around, and if you're looking at the feed from the rally bar, and you're thinking, hey, is that crazy or what? Is the rally bar actually not as crisp as the Brio? Well, the truth of the matter is that MTR on Android today doesn't actually do 4K video like the Brio does. It's a 720p currently. It's not actually the hardware that's the limiting factor right there. So I'm just going to move it around a little bit so you can get a feel for the tracking capabilities. And it'll move over here and find me on the side. I'm about two to two and a half meters away from the camera right now. And of course, my room, as you can see, I've got some acoustic panels up on the wall. So it's a pretty good room for testing audio and so on and getting a good feel for something. But there is no reverb to speak of. There is no poor audio to speak of. I'm just moving into the very far corner here, tucked away behind my fancy chair, perhaps. And right over here, I'm at least 3 meters away from the camera right now. And I'm kind of talking my day-to-day tone. So what I'll do is whilst you get a feel for the tracking capabilities and the audio capabilities, I'll pick up my old trusty book, and I'm sure you're tired of the first two pages. I'll go to page 3 just to be able to benchmark this again as I have before. They're quite big inside, said Belinda. Look, that's where the stove is. And the smoke comes out of the little chimney thing at the top. It's awful dirty inside, though. Jordan had a good look at the two caravans. They had once been painted a gay yellow and blue, but now the paint was dull and cracked. The shafts into which horses had once been backed to pull the caravans along slanted to the ground. There were no horses to be seen. Well, it seems the horse has bolted. And that is an audio test, a video test, a tracking test, an experience test of the Logi Rally Bar.